Hello, this is Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri. Today let us see what is the message to the world when we observe Lord Shiva's family. First of all, Lord Shiva is an ascetic. But after he marries Sati and Sati, jumps into the pyre of Daksha Prajapati's Yajna and she dies, and then later on he marries Parvati. Okay, so once Lord Shiva marries Parvati, he becomes engaged with the world or samsara. So he becomes Shankara. So practically when I say Shiva's family, because we use this Shiva and Shankara in the same context, that is why. So Lord Shiva or Lord Shankara's family, when we look at it, it is an amazing picture. So Lord Shiva, as we all know, he has snakes all around his body, one cobra on his neck and amulets and on his legs. So snakes are on his body. Now, what is the vehicle of Shiva? Vehicle of Shiva is Nandi bull. All right. Now, his consort Parvati is sitting on his thigh. Now, what is her vahana or her vehicle? That is a tiger. Then his son Ganesha. Ganeshji's vahan is a rat. Okay, that is also sitting there. And then his other son, that is Kumara, Kumara's vehicle or vahana is peacock. Peacock also is there. Now, if you look at this combination, okay, bull, snakes, tiger, rats and peacock, all of them are there and all of them are happy and peaceful. They're not attacking each other. Generally, snakes eat rats. We all know, right? And snakes are eaten by peacocks. And bulls and peacocks are easily eaten by tiger. But here nothing, nobody attacks anybody. Why? If you just give it a deep thought, because in Lord Shiva's presence or Shankara's presence, in Kailasha, he's abode, there is nothing called hunger. There's no hunger. Now what is this hunger? Hunger itself is desire. And as Lord Buddha says, desire is the root cause of all the unhappiness in the world. As he says, Ashai dukkha ka mool karan hai. Now, how this dukkha is created? If there is a desire, then you seek food. When you are seeking food, you lose your discrimination. You want to achieve it and then you attack each other, whatever the food chain is organized. But here, No creature is attacking other creature because it's a complete contentment. So what lesson can we derive from here? See, actually, when there is no desire, there is no fight. When there is no fight, there is no suffering. There is no, there is always peace and happiness. So this is the lesson for us to understand or learn, that if we can overcome our desire in life or keep it under control at least, then there is no enmity. When there is no enmity, there is no fight. Life will move on smoothly. So I hope you like this interpretation. Thanks for watching. Thank you.